Alright, so I'm trying to assemble this Schwinn 430. It's this elliptical type thing. It's this huge box. I pulled out the top heavy pieces over here and set them over there. And then I tilted the box on its side, sideways, over, and slid this out. So now I have to put it all together. So that's what I'm doing this weekend. Alright, so these are the tools that came with it. Allen wrench, this little T screwdriver, and this kind of wrench type deal. Probably just go get some of my tools. Alright, so step one. So I'm gonna put that thing on that. So let's do this. Okay, so this right here needs to go underneath that. So I'm gonna do the same thing. Nuts and bolts underneath. I'm guessing they just screw on those holes right there. So I gotta get this out of the plastic. I lift that up, slide this underneath it, get the holes lined up, and put the bolts on. So let me try and do that. Hold it. Okay, those are loosely on for now. I need to go open up that tool thing and see how the screwdriver works. Alright, so I got the screwdriver that came with it. It needs the Allen wrench with the screwdriver. Put tight. Okay, I need to get the Allen wrench. Okay, step one done. I got this mounted on. So what is step two? Be sure levelers are fully raised on rail assembly. Hardware is pre-installed, not on the hardware card. So I'm supposed to put this on that. It is right there. So I have the other bolt already out. Other bolts out and put this back side right there on this. So I weld this thing over into position where I want it. I gotta move this and all that other stuff put over there now. So I guess first three in here is the last one. That's the okay, that's pretty tight. So that's what it looks like. The base. Step 1 and 2. Done. Now what is step 3? It says attach the manual lift assembly using the arm pivot rod. Hardware is pre-installed, not on the hardware card. So, let's just install that thing right there. Is this thing, I believe? I need to install it. I'm gonna take it out of plastic. I got it out of plastic, that's that. Now I need to take this cardboard off. And I need a knife. Scissors. I already have this knife. Open. That other tool. Now this thing should go in. Okay. What does that say? Do I need to lift it up first? Or what's the idea? It looks like it's flat. No, it didn't. So I lift the arm up. And put the bolts in again. Oh, these things are individually. Okay, I got those on, and I tighten them back up. This part, I need these pieces from here. It was the D screws, these G spacers, and then the B washers. I already disassembled them right there, so now I need to use them to put this thing on. This man. Plastic still. I need to pull out. Yeah, let me get this out of the plastic. I already got these screws tightened. I use this rod. And you slide it in under here to keep these kind of up, and it lines up better on the diagram. So I tightened it like that. Now I'll just pull this back up. Alright, so I got this piece out of the plastic. It's supposed to have this connector piece for the electrical out, so we need to fish that out. Plug that into the other side. It's dangling out right there. Sorry, I got these bolts on. I needed someone else to hold this in place while I screwed everything in and lift this up. This plastic is sharp on the bottom, so it's scratched my hand a few times. So, lift this on finally. So now I can snap this thing back on. This little thing to wedge the plastic piece hot back off after snapping out of it on this little thing. I gotta find it wherever that is. Let's go find it.
The red thing over here.
Right? That looks like it. Snap on this plastic and put that on.
So I got it out of the plastic, and
directions say like this, slide it around it, okay, that's it. Alright, that is the next step. I'm done with this page. Now I gotta put these arm things on.
Alright, so I got these unbagged. And it says I need two of these
between the arm and this. Okay. Sign right here. Alright. Here's this arm. inside. I need to get these bolts on both ones. So A, G, C for each side. Then put these on. Okay, now those ones are on. Next is this rod I'm supposed to go in between here. So I can mount some other stuff on. Three, there. Number three goes there. So I can put these in 7 and 17 on. It's the next step. 6. Alright, so I got it out of the bag. Just gonna go. It's not going in very well. Alright, so I lubed it up a little. Some of this grease that I have inside, these little holes. Now my hands all slippery. Much better with the lube. See, I won't go through it all the way. It's stuck. Hang on there. Can't see it. But this last edge, it's right there. So, I got this rubber mallet. I'm just gonna tap it the rest of the way through. So I tap that through. Now it looks kind of even. If I was hitting it, this edge would pop out right here. So I had to push that back in. Alright, now what's next? Next is7 and 17. And another F bracket in between. So I'm gonna grab an F. This goes here. So I got these unwrapped. Now I need to slide them on. Hopefully this is easy, not as hard as the last one. Get that one's on. But I need to square this up. See, this side pops out. Okay. this.
Very good.
Okay. Both arms. Now I need to bolt them in place. So I need these E, G, and C pieces. So I got my hardware all set up. Okay. That was around. Now what? Next page. Alright, so for this step, this is 2x and 2x. You're only supposed to put one. So I need to remove this leg and pull off one of these Fs on both sides and then put it back in so I can use the other F spacer somewhere else. That's a confusing remark. So now, I have to pull this bottom thing off, the other side too, this arm, so I can get the spacer out. Alright, so I got the extra two back out, and put the legs back on. Didn't take me too long, so... Now, I was on step 7, I can use them there where they should go. So, I'm not gonna mount this, or should I do that first? So is this above, so I'm gonna do this first. A, G, and C. Slide that in, with this H bracket. So I'm going to hold that in, and then this will keep that H bracket in place. Okay, I got that on. It's supposed to slide into that. Front's supposed to mount in there. Got that slid in. Now I need to bend up the bolt there. Okay. Now, next step is this part. Already got it partially in. Down here. And you get it the rest of the way in. Oh. So this is where I am. One leg attached. Where to go in the upper part. Alright, well, I got both sides on. So. I gotta put the top parts on. Alright, step 8. Test the upper handlebar arms to frame assembly. No, hardware is pre-installed and not on the hardware card. Make sure upper handlebar arms are secure before you exercise. Whoops. Okay, I got this first arm mounted in place. Now I need to put the second one on. You said that. Do these 4 bolts. First take them off, and then put them back in after I slid the arm back in. It's pretty easy. Alright, now I got a second handle on. These bolts. Right side and left side. So I need to put whatever goes on there. Step 9. Drop cables and attach the static handlebar to frame assembly. So I need to pull some cable out of here. Run it through something. Through nothing. So numbered. Piece 2. So let's go find that. Alright, you got this upper handlebar section in place. So there's this one, two, and another one on the side. So 3 of these, I had to pull them off and then just put them back on and slide this through while I did that. Just added this cup holder thing in the middle. I had to remove the screw and slide this thing. And where these little screws are already mounted to both sides, and then just re-screw this back in. And that's all. I tightened down these on the sides too afterward. And now this thing is complete. There it is. All fully assembled.